I'm an infectious disease doctor here at Goshen Health, and I've spent a lot of time in the last 2 years studying COVID, learning about COVID, taking care of COVID patients. There are a number of reasons why COVID and the flu are dangerous for people with heart disease. COVID's really impactful on the heart because of the stress it puts on your whole body.
My name is Blair McPhail. I'm an interventional cardiologist at Goshen Heart and Vascular Center. And each person's a little different in how their body responds to those stimuli.
It's usually about day 7, sometimes day 10, where the virus will have put a real strain on the body and on the heart in particular. With that increased inflammation that we start to see heart attacks or heart arrhythmias, irregular rhythms of the heart that can be fatal.
A common rhythm disturbance is atrial fibrillation. We see a high incidence of that in patients that are hospitalized or end up in the ICU. And it's associated with a higher mortality. So when the atrium becomes very fast and irregular, as in atrial fibrillation, fortunately, the heart keeps beating on its own. It beats faster than usual, but you lose the efficiency of the heart. So the heart no longer is as an efficient pump. And when that happens, then the blood will swirl in the upper chamber of the heart, and that can form clots. And that's the big risk of atrial fibrillation, is you worry that one of those blood clots will break loose and go to the brain or one of the other organs. And we've certainly seen all of that. In COVID patients, the clotting tends to be more aggressive. And so you'll suck the clot out, you'll use all the usual blood thinners and more. And it just is impressive how vigorous the clotting is and how much you have to remove and clean up with blood clot dissolving medications. 2 or 3 days later, a few of those patients will start having symptoms again, and you'll have to go back and treat the clot again and open the artery up again. So that's pretty impressive, because usually we don't see that aggressiveness. Long COVID is a term that's being given to the patients who have ongoing symptoms that interfere with their lifestyle or interfere with them living their lives normally. About 10% of the time, people have ongoing symptoms that just don't seem to resolve for up to a year, maybe longer. And one of the early pieces of information is many of those patients will have ongoing inflammatory markers, as if their immune systems are continued to be activated and respond to the original infection in an ongoing fashion.
If I could say one thing about heart disease and COVID to the community, I think I would tell them that the most important thing to know is that it can be prevented with vaccination.
They say an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure, and that's really true with your health. Make your risk of something bad happening less.
You can't undo the damage to your heart from a significant heart attack. You may not be able to undo the damage from a significant arrhythmia or irregular heart rhythm, but you can prevent the vast majority of those things from happening by getting vaccinated and keeping yourself out of the hospital.